Welcome to Classic Picks of 80's Sticks. And for today's video, we're going to be talking about the very sexy topic of grommets. If you're planning on buying an 80's racket, something that you should consider is the condition of the grommets. The grommets can make or break your buy here. If you're planning on hanging the racket up for decoration, then you don't have to watch the rest of this video. But if you're planning on actually hitting with the racket and restringing the racket, stay tuned. So let's first go over what grommets are. They are made out of plastic and nylon, and they provide insulation protection between the racket frame and the strings. The problem with 80's rackets is that the grommets are 40 years old, and they dry out, and sometimes they crack or they actually disintegrate. So without this layer of protection, again, it could render the racket useless. The string may grind against the frame. You try to restring it, the string pops or it damages the frame, where the string is being pulled, rubbing against the frame. If you string your own rackets and you string an 80's racket or any racket with poor grommets, it's going to be an especially tough string job, because the grommet tubes provide a kind of guide for the strings to get through your racket, through the string holes. And if that tube, that guide, isn't there, the string may get caught up in the middle of your racket. And it makes it very difficult sometimes, especially with 80's rackets. Why? Because 80's rackets are more likely to have shared string holes, and it makes it that much more difficult. I pulled my hair out on a number of rackets that had poor grommets that had also shared string holes, and it would take me 10, 15 plus minutes just to get the string through the actual frame of the racket to the other side, because the grommet tubes weren't there because of the poor condition of them.
Now, what if you have a racket that you absolutely love and you can't go on with life without it? It's from the 80's. The grommets are shot. All right, there's a few things you could do. First of all, you could tell your stringer, if you don't string rackets, or if you string rackets, you could use a ton of this, the Teflon tubing. But that only works to a certain extent, all right? And it's kind of a pain in the rear end, especially with shared holes. Using Teflon with shared holes is a art, if you could make it work, all right? So, Let me see if I get. You saw the TXE that I showed with Teflon tubing there. Where is it? There it is. Why? Again, to protect the string from rubbing against the frame. Another option is to use Fitex grommets.
These are individual aftermarket grommets that come in many different sizes.
I have a few packages in different lengths. They come in different lengths and diameters, because frames are different widths or thicknesses around the head. So in the shoulder area, if I get my graphite edge here, the grommet is going to see it's thicker at the throat there, so the tube has to be longer. Whereas at the tip of the head, the tube's going to be shorter. So there's different lengths for these Fitex grommets. Some of them are really long, like this one. And of course, diameters. Diameters, there are different diameters, thicker and thinner, depending on the racket and where you're placing the grommets. These can be cut. But you notice the ones stock, the tips are, they're kind of not sharpened, but they narrow down when you cut them with a cutting tool. It's usually just flat, but you got to be careful sometimes, because that could put stress on the string. So you can use these, and let's say a racket doesn't have any grommets. You took them out because they're totally shot. So let's say I took out all these grommets from this head TXE.
I can put the Fitex grommets in each hole. All right, I would just place this in the hole. Something like this. Put this in the hole here, and it would protect the string and the frame from rubbing against each other. How is it held in place? The Fitex grommets are like an L, kind of. They have a little, I call it the anchor, so it doesn't slip through the hole. But a couple things about these Fitex grommets is that, number one, I think the anchor needs to be a little bit wider. Some of these 80s rackets, the frames get soft, and if you have decent tension above 50, and some people like to string their rackets like they did in the 60s, I'm sorry, in the 80s, in the 60-pound range or above, these grommets will definitely dig into the frame, all right, and then make indentations to the frame, and could possibly, and I've seen it on some of the graphite edges I have, enlarge the hole. Here's another possible option. If you don't have a pristine kind of a new grommet for your old racket, you could use old grommets that are still parts of it that are okay. So it doesn't have to be all of it okay. If there's parts of an old grommet that you have, you could reuse that. Or you could use and cut up grommets from other rackets and use bits and pieces of it. Like here I have a little bit and piece. This isn't a great example because I'm going to use this example in a second. You'll see why. You notice that it's broken at the end. I'll tell you why in a minute. But let's say you have a piece of a good grommet like this. You could use this for part of your racket and find other bits and pieces and cut them up from different grommets. Maybe a newer racket grommet. Alright? For example, I have this. This is not a Fitex grommet. Notice it's square right there. It's from another grommet set. Cut it up. And you can insert that, and it works fine. I'll show you an example of a Frankenstein racket. Here's a graphite edge I put together with a bunch of different grommet sections. Now this is not the cleanest, but it works. Turn it over here. See, there's a section there. There's one for one hole. So I have sections for maybe 3-4 holes here, but you could Frankenstein grommets to fit. All right, some of these were from different rackets. Some of these were from other graphite edges where parts of those or sections of those grommets were still decent to use. So this racket now has life again. I could string it again. So again, another option. In case you have a racket that needs grommets, but you can't find any. Going back to this piece of grommet, I want to mention this. This may be the future of prolonging the longevity of 80's rackets. This is actually a 3D printed section of a graphite edge grommet. I went through the effort of having a new old stock grommet scan and then print it. And it was a, they did a great job and it came out perfect. They used multi-jet fusion printer. It doesn't do layers, that type of 3D printing. I'm not an expert on that. You guys may know about the different types of 3D printing. This was done on an industrial printer, not on a home printer that does it with the filaments and the layers. This was using basically, I don't know, not dust, but it doesn't use filament per se, like a string. It uses a different type of a process of putting the material together, which is supposed to be a little bit stronger. So there's not really layers, but the reason why there's a missing grommet there and it's not a whole section is because it's not there. The technology, or I should say the material, isn't there.
If I press this just with a little bit of pressure, this will break. All right. So I have pictures of one of the rackets I strung using these 3D printed grommets, and it didn't last one string job. It cracked, it broke when pulling the string. So it looks really good, it looks perfect. You couldn't tell just by looking at it. But just the material isn't there. I know there's new material. I know that with the home printers, there's flexible material, the Ninja Flex and stuff. I tried that too. And that's a little bit too rubbery, but I still don't think it's there. I think it's close though. I did read about Head using 3D printing for part of one of its kind of a high-tech rackets a few years ago. I don't know what material they use. I'd like to find out, because if they can make it work, then others. So I know people with Wilson Pro Staffs, 6-0s, St. Vincent, you know, they're missing they're in need of grommets, and you see some of the grommets up on eBay for 50, 60, 70, all the way up to $100. And if we get 3D printing going, that may solve the shortage of these grommets. So a helpful trick that could help you with installing grommets, and also possibly allow you to put some of the stiffer grommets due to age back in your racket, heat up some water and just put your grommet in to the water, kind of like spaghetti in a way. And you don't want to boil it too long, and you don't even want to put it in boiling water, but put it in warm water. It will really loosen up the grommet, make it much more flexible. Now, will it be stronger? That's doubtful, but it will make it easier to put in and make it a little more flexible. You can also use a heat gun or a hair dryer, and you can just heat up the grommet. For Head racket users, there is another possible option. Head tends to use their same racket molds for a period of time, so these cap grommets that are still available could possibly fit older 80s rackets like this Head Graphite Pro. This Head Graphite Pro had those white grommet and head protectors that crumbled and disintegrated very quickly. So these now have a new lease on life with these new cap grommets, and I can still get these, so I could probably play with this one for a long time to come. So to sum it up, if you're considering buying a 80s racket, most likely from the big auction website, take into consideration the condition of the grommets. There are many times where I've seen the auctions listing the racket in excellent mint, very good condition, and that may very well be true in regards to the condition of the frame, but again, with the age, the grommets, even if not used, will eventually deteriorate and render the racket basically unusable. That's it for now. Thanks a lot for sticking around. Please subscribe if you haven't, and if you have any comments you'd like to share, any experiences, please use the comment section below. Thanks a lot.